weeks. We're back on drive time. Vernon Howe, episode 12B. I had a good day today so far. It's freezing out there. Holy shit. Does it look cold in the sky? Does it look cold in the sky? Is the sky cold? I bet the sky is colder than it is here, which is pretty cold. It can't get warm soon enough. Done with this. I don't know. Complain a lot about the weather, but... Oh, he's gonna hit that raccoon. Oh my god. There's a dead raccoon outside my work. Poor guy, really splattered. And I was here, I was on this road last night. Kinda late. And, he was not there, so to think that he was alive less than 12, 15 hours ago, now he's not alive. Dead raccoons. Raccoons die. No raccoon has ever lived forever. Don't know that. That's the truth. I thought the bad weather was supposed to start already, but, we are. I have a project coming out, and I'm just going to talk about it now real quickly. It's called Alcoholics Anonymous, and it's what it is it's 40, and I have a lot of work to do on it. The concept is solidified, and I actually just bought the URL. The project is 40 stories. I guess you could call them stories. They're very short. Each one is between 160 and 170 words long. And they're just kind of like fantastical. Is that, if I can use that word? Can I use that word? Did I just make that word up? I don't think so. I think I know that what that means, and I think that accurately describes what I'm talking about. You know, even if it's not a real word, which I'm 90% sure it is, I should just own it. It's fantastical. The stories are kind of weird. They're odd. They're oddball stories. I'm gonna turn the heat up because I'm fucking cold in my car. Hopefully it gets fired up. I apologize for the sound. The stories are odd. One involves a boy whose feet are salamanders, and one of the salamanders fingers a girl at a high school dance. Something like that. One's about pizza. I think there's multiple ones about pizza. They're fun. I think I hopefully that they're silly, but they're fun and they're kind of dark, and also, you know, maybe you can get something out of them. Oh my god. Wow, I almost hit a goose. That goose did not obey the arrangement. Especially geese. You would think that geese would have moved. I mean, he was 2 feet over my car. He blended in with the kind of color of the road, and I didn't see him until it was right on top of him. And he didn't, like, flinch. He just stayed right where he was. Like, he was just, like, walking like he knew he was gonna be okay. I wish I had the confidence of that goose. I'm gonna have chicken parm in a little bit. I got leftover chicken parm. My mom made me special chicken parm yesterday. I might make it some potato salad, too. To go with it. It's a good idea, actually. Do we have time to do that? Yeah, why not? I should take that one out. A little mayo. A little vinegar. Some seasoning. What goes in a potato salad? I'll probably, you know, that's a good idea. I'll make the potato salad. Sorry to talk about my food. I've been, you know, watching what I've been eating. I've been shedding some pounds. Slowly. You know, I'm not going crazy. I had that ice cream last night. Did I talk about the ice cream? I did. Last episode, I talked about the ice cream. The cotton candy with the Pop Rocks in it. Oh, amazing. Amazing. Just really mind-blowing stuff in ice cream technology. was Friendly's brand. Which is not like, you know, the actual ice cream is like not... The concept of the Pop Rocks is really the, the only worthwhile innovative thing, I think. You know, the ice cream itself is, you know, it's not Ben & Jerry's. It's not Häagen-Dazs. Look at me. I'm an ice cream snob. Breyers is very good. Blue Bunny, underrated. Probably out of the cheaper varieties, that's probably the... It's just quality of the flavor of the ice cream itself. I would say Blue Bunny is the, best bang for your buck. Then you got, what, Turkey Hill and Edie's. Those are kind of below the Blue Bunny. I'll put Blue Bunny above them. Some people wouldn't. I think Blue Bunny is considered not as good. Maybe it's on par with what most people think about ice cream. You know, nothing beats a good homemade ice cream from an ice cream joint at the Jersey Shore. Whenever you like to go, those are always good. I'm not a big soft ice cream fan. Never have been. And I don't like ice cream cones. As soon as I was of age to use utensils, I was done eating things with my hand. I was fine with the utensils. I acknowledged mankind's... you know what happened was? When I first was old enough to start using forks and spoons, I had a instinct kick in that was kind of a... giving props to the evolutionary process. Saying, yeah, tools. We got this, humanity. I'm not going to use my hands. I don't want an ice cream cone. What is it? The ice cream cone has no flavor. It's just chalky. And I knew back then it was empty carbs. Give me the cup with the spoon. Give me the cup.